Hey there, I'm Lucinda, and I'm a second year ecological engineering major and a College of Engineering ambassador at Oregon State, and I'm from Sycamore, Illinois. Today I'll be taking you with me on a day in my life. As an engineering major, the workload can be pretty high, so I always try to build in time for studying and homework into my schedule. It's a Thursday, which means I only have two classes today, but it's still gonna be quite busy. After my classes, I'm meeting with some of my fellow ambassadors to study for our tours. Then my friend Hannah and I are going to a cafe downtown to work on our statics homework. And if I have time after that, I'll be going to climbing club. And at the end of the day, there might be another fun little surprise in store. I live about a mile from the center of campus, so I usually bike to my classes. There's plenty of bike lanes in Corvallis, and all the drivers are used to sharing the road, so you can feel safe in the bike lanes.
It is 9:30, which usually is a little early, but I have to bike to the south side of campus, and also I like to be at my classes early. And it's only like a 10-minute bike lane, but whatever. So I'll see you at campus.
Okay, I haven't actually left my house yet, but I just wanted to show you. The beetle has been here for like 3 days, being sort of eaten by this spider, but like, still alive. I think that's kind of awesome. Just been thinking about that.
My first class today is my statics studio, where we're just working on an activity based on what we're learning in lecture. After that, I have my physics lab. This week, we're designing an experiment based on angular acceleration. My Tuesdays and Thursdays are pretty weird this term because I only have one or two two-hour classes.
Okay, it is now 2 p.m. and I'm hanging out outside of Johnson Hall with Lily.
Hi.
Who is another College of Engineering ambassador. And we are meeting with some of our coworkers to practice for tours. And basically, the tours are like a 22-page script that we have to memorize. The thing we did not realize is that they are giving tours right now, which we forgot about. So we may or may not be actually running through the route.
Campus is like its own little town, and it's unbelievably beautiful any time of year. In the fall, the leaves cover the ground and the colors are so breathtaking. In the winter, the occasional snow and ice paints everything white and really accentuates the buildings. And in the spring, there are so many different flowers blooming all at once, which is awful if you have allergies, but so worth it. I have a bunch of secret study spots that I like to gatekeep. But one of my favorite that I'll reveal is the PV Forestry building. It's usually pretty empty and it has some very, very comfortable couches.
We just finished practicing our tours and so now we're sitting here. Now we're sitting here and studying a little bit. You know, doing some physics. Statics and studying for tours because that's the life of an engineer.
Hi, we are back at my house now. I know this day has kind of been all over the place. The engineering schedule is very busy, especially when you also want to keep a social life. The main reason I chose engineering, and I know everybody has a different answer, everybody chooses, comes up with it at a different time. Some people don't even realize they want to be an engineer until they're in college, which is awesome. Or some people don't even realize until like they've graduated and they've like have a degree and they're like, wait a minute, I want another one. Basically, in eighth grade, we had a unit about like, I think it was sustainable energy. And he started talking about carbon sequestration. I was like, holy cow, that's crazy. I don't know why this like blew my mind. I stumbled across ecological engineering. It's not at many schools, and it's very unique. And it's basically using natural processes and systems to solve human-made problems and to work in conjunction with nature to solve those problems. And I loved that. Like, that was exactly what I wanted. So I was like, OSU, OSU all the way.
Corvallis is an amazing town with so much to do. There's so much hiking nearby, a variety of indie music, a bunch of cute shops downtown, as well as tons of good food. My friend Hannah and I just got some fire vegetarian food at Bodhi. Every once in a while, my friends and I will take the hour-long drive to the coast and explore the city of Newport. Also, there's a ton of good climbing spots within an hour, or three if you want to drive to Smith Rock. Mary's Peak is also only an hour drive away and provides the most beautiful view of Corvallis that you could possibly imagine. I took a trip up there tonight to catch the Northern Lights and I just barely missed them, but the trip was still so worth it. It was a fun excuse to see some friends and they got some pretty awesome pics too.
Well, we're now at Rivas in Corvallis. It's one of the only 24/7 places. It's awesome. Just got back down from Mary's Peak. I got some fish tacos. Look at this.
Holy cow.
Some of our other friends just got here. We'll be going home shortly. It is pretty late. Honestly though, this is the college experience, so.
It's about just past midnight.
kind of a long day.
My days are not usually like this, but I like to say yes to things to an extent. It's possible to do too much. So honestly, it's picking and choosing what you want to do, what you don't want to do, what you have time for, what you don't. I hope you enjoyed my day. I certainly did. All right, that's good night.
My life is literally a movie.